Good morning. Priest intentions for this morning's Mass are for Bill Rathbone by his wife Patricia. Please remember to silence your cell phones, and there will be benediction following Mass, or exposition of the Blessed Sacrament following Mass with benediction to follow at 10 o'clock. If you're not planning to stay, we ask that you hold your conversation until you're outside of the building.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Good morning, everyone. As we gather this morning to celebrate these sacred mysteries of God's love, let us take a moment as we begin to the Father's presence, and we ask him to grace us with his mercy, his forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do. through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, O Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. Now, Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. O God, who in your mercy led St. Clare to a love of poverty, grant through her intercession that following Christ in poverty of spirit, we may merit to contemplate you one day in the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The Lord God said to me, "As for you, son of man, obey me when I speak to you. Be not rebellious like this house of rebellion, but open your mouth and eat what I shall give you." It was then I saw a hand stretched out to me, in which was a written scroll, which he unrolled before me. It was covered with writing front and back, and written on it was lamentation and wailing and woe. He said to me, "Son of man, eat what is before you. Eat this scroll, then go, speak to the house of Israel." So I opened my mouth, and he gave me the scroll to eat. "Son of man," he then said to me, "feed your belly and fill your stomach with this scroll I am giving you." I ate it, and it was sweet as honey in my mouth. He said, "Son of man, go now to the house of Israel and speak my words to them." The word of the Lord. How sweet to my taste is your promise. In the way of your decrees I rejoice as much as in all riches. How sweet to my taste is your promise. Yes, your decrees are my delight. They are my counselors. How sweet to my taste is your promise. The law of your mouth is to me more precious than the thousands of gold and silver pieces. How sweet is your promise. How sweet to my taste are your promises, sweeter than honey to my mouth. How sweet to my taste is your promise. Your decrees are my inheritance forever, the joy of my heart they are. How sweet to my taste is your promise. I gasp with open mouth in my yearning for your commands. How sweet to my taste is your promise.
My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The disciples approached Jesus and said, "Who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?" He called a child over placed it in their midst and said, Amen, I say to you, unless you turn and become like children, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven. Whoever becomes humble like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever receives one child, such as this in my name receives me. See that you do not despise one of these little ones. For I say to you that their angels in heaven always look upon the face of my heavenly Father. What is your opinion? If a man has 100 sheep and one of them goes astray, will he not leave the 99 in the hills and go and search astray? And if he finds it, amen, I say to you, he rejoices more over it than over the 99 that did not stray. In just the same way, it is not the will of your heavenly Father that one of these little ones be lost. The Gospel of the Lord. Sometimes we need virtues in our lives to make something look real for us. Anyone who's a teacher knows that not all our students learn the same way. Some students, they need that persist. They need to see it in order to believe it. It took me back a little bit to yesterday when I was talking about taking a look at that green. I said, place that piece of green in your hand and take a look at it. And to see in that grain of wheat what possibly could grow. Ezekiel this morning gives us a visual to think about. About the word of the Lord. How sweet was the word of the Lord to his power. Of course, what we all need, that really, really, really tasted good. Oh, it was good. Because we had the vision. It looked good. The presentation was good. Everything leading up to that taste was very good, so why would the meal not be very good? But we visualized all of that. What Ezekiel's trying to do is tell us how deep is the word of the Lord. And when we take hold of it, it's very, very good for us. Today we celebrate a humble religious, St. Clare of Assisi, who was known to be a writer and a preacher of the word of the Lord to the poor and to the marginalized, the founder of a contemplative group, poor Clare's. But yet, she which made her want to give her life to the Lord. She wanted to take that word, and she wanted everyone to feel, have a feeling for that word that she had in her own life. Yes, at times the Lord gives us that visual again today. There goes that lost one again, just let him be lost. I got my 99, I'm okay. But are we? But are we okay? Is that 99th or that, is that one, the one that really needs us? Is that one, the one we really want to implant the word of the Lord in? That's the challenge. Sometimes it is the one that is more challenging to us than the other 99. It's that itch. It's the one that's constantly calling for attention. Why? Why? Because he wants you to visualize him, to single him out. The Lord singles each and every one of us out. At times we are that one that needs that special attention. It needs that special calling from the Lord to fulfill us, so that the Lord, that the word of the Lord can become sweet even unto us. So today as we approach the table and receive the Lord in the sacrament of the Eucharist, and may the Eucharist we receive to the dead be for us that visual sign of the presence of Christ in our lives. May God be blessed. So let us take a moment in prayer and lift up our own particular needs. Heavenly Father, these are our needs which we place before you this day. We ask it in your name. We ask you to grant them that they be your will. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through this we have received the bread we offer you for the earth and work of human hands. Come for us, a bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through this we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. Come our spiritual drink. Pray now, my brothers and sisters, in my sacrifice and yours, it be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, proclaim your wonders, O Lord, in the Virgin Blessed, St. Clare. We humbly implore your majesty that as her merits are pleasing to you, so too our dutiful service may find favor in your sight through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My friends, the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you called human nature back to its original holiness, and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promised in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us a body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more, giving thanks, he said the blessing. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me. A mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you with thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognize the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by his body and blood, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Francis de Sales and Jean de Chantel and St. Clare and all your saints whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for the filling help. And may the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Please and confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Frank, our Bishop, all the bishops with the clergy, the entire people who gain from the Lord. And listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you with your passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, in Christ our Lord, whom you bestow on the world all that is good. For through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. The Savior's command, and formed by my teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And deliver us, Lord, from every evil. And graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously, grant us peace and unity according to your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us give each other a wave. Behold, Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called on the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray our prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Oh, I cannot now receive you sacramentally. Please come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you, and I myself holy to you. Amen. Let us pray. Renewed by partaking of these divine gifts, we pray, O Lord our God, that by the example of the blessed Saint Clare, bearing in our body the death of Jesus, we may strive to hold fast to you alone, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our prayer for the canonization of Father Brisson. Lord Jesus, you have told us, ask and you shall receive. We address our prayer to you through the intercession of your priest, Louis Brisson. Attentive to the signs of the times and obedience to your will, we founded the double fan of the Oblate Sisters and the Oblates of St. Francis de Sales. Confident in your providence and joyful in hope, he knew as a good father how to make himself all things to all people. Grant us through his intercession the favors which we ask of you, especially. May the Holy Church rejoice and glorify this priest after your own heart, giving himself totally to your love. Amen. And my brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. Amen. May Almighty God bless each and every one of us today and always. His Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and proclaim the gospel of the Lord. Let's all have a beautiful day, everybody.